organic, unpredictable, unknown, lovely, beautiful, a sense of fulfillment. This is part of the pleasures of life and not the chores of life.
Coming up tonight on Daily Iowan TV, students only have a few more days to drop that class that could sink their GPA.
And a familiar face is set to read from her latest memoir in an Iowa City church.
Week 9 of college football has arrived in Iowa City.
Coming up in sports, Maryland is looking for their first Big Ten conference win, while Iowa is looking to stay hot and undefeated.
All that and more coming up.
Daily Iowan TV starts now.
Good evening, thanks for joining us. I'm Austin Love.
And I'm Alara Bartlett. For UI students struggling in their schoolwork, November 2nd will be the last day they can drop a class. But if they do, they'll have a W printed on their transcript. Daily Iowan TV's Katie Sexto explores the risk or reward of taking that red mark.
Students have about 6 more weeks of studying and only have a few more days until they can no longer drop a class if they need to. But it can be hard for students to decide between dropping a class and risk getting a bad grade.
If a student is failing a course or worries that they won't pass, they're encouraged to come talk to an advisor about their options.
The Senior Associate Director at the Academic Advising Center, Maureen Schaefer, said the first step students should take is to meet with their professor to see if it's possible to raise their grade.
The best thing for them to do, not only to understand really where they stand grade-wise, but also to talk about their behavior in the class in terms of what effort they've put forth up to this point and maybe what needs to change moving forward.
And if hours of studying wouldn't help pull their grade up, students may need to consider dropping. A class dropped this late results in a W that stands for withdrawn on the student's transcript. And that scares some students.
I definitely worried about dropping it, and I asked my teacher if there was anything I could do to fix my grade before I dropped it, but there wasn't, so I didn't really have a choice.
But Schaefer emphasizes that a W is not a bad thing and looks better than an F on a transcript. It's only a problem if it becomes a pattern.
It's in the student's best interest to drop a class that might not get any better, because then they can focus on the remaining classes and perhaps do better in those classes.
Schaefer says you shouldn't use this as an excuse to get out of those hard classes, but if it's best for you and your GPA to drop, don't sweat it too much. Reporting from the University of Iowa, Katie Sextro, Daily Iowan TV.
Iowa City High School students are getting hands-on training as police officers and first responders. The public safety program that began last year currently has 7 cadets, preparing them for possible careers in emergency response and crime scene investigation. The costs to run the program are covered within a community policing fund, including the fees for CPR and first aid certification. The program is one of many around the country that focuses on teen law enforcement training.
Famed Hollywood actress and writer Drew Barrymore is slated to speak in Iowa City on Thursday evening. Barrymore is well known for her numerous acting performances, including her unforgettable role in 51st States, a romantic comedy with Adam Sandler. Barrymore is here in Iowa City to speak about her new book, Wildflower, which is about her experiences growing up independently since she was 14 and the impact it had on her development. The sold-out event, hosted by Prairie Lights, will take place at First United Methodist Church on Dubuque Street, starting at 7 p.m. Well, Austin, it got pretty cold pretty quickly, and it's definitely fall now.
Yeah, it is definitely fall. It is cold, and probably impacts some costumes tonight and this weekend downtown Iowa City. But we'll see. We'll toss over to Ashley Kruger to see what the weather is in store for this Halloween weekend. Ashley?
Heading into Friday morning, we are looking at a chilly 38 degrees. It doesn't get much warmer as the day goes on, rising only slightly to 54 degrees in the afternoon with partly cloudy skies. Then in the evening, temperatures drop to 49 degrees. We are not seeing temperatures go into a downward spiral just yet, but it doesn't look like such a warm welcome for football fans. The first game after the bye week this Saturday is going to be rainy with a high of 53 and a low of 42. Luckily, it looks like that rain is going to stop around 3 p.m., saving Halloween goers from being drenched. Then Sunday gives us something to look forward to with daylight savings time as we fall back 1 hour. Getting into the week might be a bit of a shock, with highs in the 60s and 70s and lows around the 50s with clear skies. That's all I have for you here at the Weather Studio. Back to you guys at the desk.
The University of Iowa Dance Marathon is hosting speakers and events to hype students up for this February's fundraiser. Zach Johnson, the vice president of the National Dance Marathon Network, is the latest inspiration to fuel students' fire. Daily Iowan TV's Nikki Crosswaite has the story.
As part of the educational series, Dance Marathon invited the man who makes this organization possible across the nation. Zach Johnson spoke on generational theory. He instilled in the audience that the millennial generation has the most power to influence the world today.
We've got a lot of potential and we've got a lot of power to make change. And I just would hate for anybody in the audience to ever get discouraged because someone tells them they can't, someone tells them our generation isn't worthwhile, when it's the farthest thing from the truth. We really do have the power to make the world a better place.
After Zach asked students what stereotypes their generation faces, he goes on to defend them and share what other generations don't realize the millennial generation is doing for the future. His inspirational words were also accompanied with personal stories meeting Dancing in Our Hearts kiddos.
He was so inspirational. It was incredible. I usually don't go to lectures, and I was like, okay, I have to hear this one because he's a big deal. And I came, and it was moving. Like, the stories that he told about the kiddos was great.
He received lots of applause and appreciation from the audience. After his speech, he stuck around to talk with students who will be participating in this year's dance marathon.
I believe strongly in a lot of the things that he was saying and how we're very passionate about helping others, and that goes to show through Dance Marathon, as we spoke about tonight.
Even younger audience members were motivated.
We all have dreams. Like, I could be a doctor, or an actor, or an architect, or something. But if I work for it, it'll actually happen. So that's kind of what I took away from this.
Today actually marks 100 days out till the actual marathon. Reporting from the IMU, Nikki Crosswaite, Daily Iowan TV.
And Alara, it turns out there are actually two Zach Johnsons in Iowa City this weekend.
That's right, Austin. Iowa football announced Thursday that the 2015 Open Championship winner, Zach Johnson, who is from Iowa City, is the team's honorary captain for Saturday's home football game.
So for more on that Zach Johnson and the looming game on Saturday, let's toss it over to Danny and Taylor in the sports studio for another edition of Hawkeye Pregame. What's up, guys?
Thanks, Lauren. Austin, it will be a homecoming for Zach Johnson on Saturday. He actually grew up in Cedar Rapids.
I got the chance to see him play at the John Deere Classic this past summer. It was crazy how many fans were following him throughout the course.
Yeah, same thing when I was there 2 years ago. Big group for Zach. As for football, however, the Maryland Terrapins are coming into Kinnick Stadium, facing their third-ranked opponent in their last four games.
This number 10 Iowa football team is hungry after their bye week, especially the offense.
Iowa quarterback C.J. Beathard has been the key component to what is making this offense work.
There's no question about that, Danny, but Beathard has been pressured by opponents continuously in the pocket, making his full strength questionable. And I checked in on how Iowa's quarterback is dodging injuries that could keep him out of the starting lineup.
C.J. Beathard is the first quarterback in Iowa school history to win his first eight career starts.
It's a special team, it's a special feeling. We knew that before the season started. It's a special group of guys, and I think we realize that as players and as coaches, and we got something special here. We just got to act upon it and focus and play our game.
What this quarterback has done is create a dynamic pass game, run game, and even kept the ball for himself. But there have been some concerns about if Beathard is at 100%.
I'm getting there. I don't think I'm fully 100% yet, but every day it's getting better. So
rumors floated around the sports world week 7 of the Northwestern game. But sure enough, the quarterback was in the pocket when the warm-up clock hit zero. There were moments in that game where Beathard was noticeably struggling with his right leg.
I'm still trying to improve my movement and mobility.
The quarterback did get some time off, though, during the bye week.
He's been working. Yeah, he's been working. We gave him the majority of last week off, which was good for him, and a couple other guys in that same category. So he's been working, and he's throwing the ball well.
With his mobility limited, Beathard might have to rely more on the men behind him for the run game. But that has seemed to be no trouble for them.
Beathard won't be going against an easy defense, though.
That's right. Maryland has an impressive backfield that Iowa needs to look out for. Jordan Maloney has more on how Iowa and Maryland look head-to-head.
Ranked number 3 in the nation, the Hawkeyes' rushing defense has dominated this season,
allowing only one touchdown and averaging 74.1 yards per game. The Terrapins, on the other hand, come in at number 73, letting up 15 rushing touchdowns and averaging 175.6 yards per game. On the opposite side of the ball, two junior quarterbacks will go head-to-head on Saturday. Iowa's C.J. Beathard has averaged 61% completion this season and has thrown only three interceptions. On the other sideline, Perry Hill has 52.8% completion percentage with seven interceptions. While the quarterbacks always play a huge role, the most interesting position matchup between the teams are the punt-returning defensive backs, Maryland's Will Likely and Iowa's Desmond King. Likely leads the Big Ten, averaging 19.9 yards per return, while King comes in a close second with a 15.7 yard average. Jordan Maloney, Daily Iowan TV Sport.
Maryland is a team that Iowa can't look past though, and there are specifically 62.5%, thanks to Coach Ferentz for that math, of Iowa's Big Ten schedule left. Even with Iowa's 7-0 start, members of the national media are questioning Iowa's strength of schedule. Zach Mackey tells us why.
It's been a hot topic all throughout college football last week, the strength of Iowa's football schedule. Many national media outlets have picked up the topic as the crew of ESPN College Game Day looked at the remaining schedule, and lead analyst Kurt Herbstreit called it almost embarrassing. As Coach Ferentz mentions, there is still a lot of conference games to be played.
2.5 to be exact, percent of our Big Ten schedule to play yet. So, yeah, to worry about those things is really kind of silly. And really, you know, you get defined by what you do on the field. The best thing we can do right now is just worry about this game. You know, we got a real big game coming up with Maryland, a team that beat us last year.
Iowa's strength of schedule is ranked 36th in the country, which puts them higher than Baylor, TCU, Ohio State, and Clemson, to name a few. Iowa is also one of two teams who have had multiple road top 25 victories, as the Hawks knocked off Wisconsin and Northwestern to join the likes of Alabama. Some Hawkeyes would rather fly under the radar than have the target on their back.
We were flying under the radar there for a little bit, which I mean, made it a little easier not to get caught up in all the, no offense to you guys, but like the media and all the hype and everything.
The Hawks are excited about the 7-0 start, but are even more excited about what the future holds.
You know, there's still five games left in the regular season, and that's a lot of games, five Big Ten games. You know, we really haven't done much. We've won every game that we've been presented with, and you know, that's a big accomplishment for us. But there's so much more and so much more we want to do. So we just got to keep looking ahead, take it week by week.
For Daily Iowa TV Sports, I'm Zach Mackey.
The true test as to how good this football team really is will be determined at how they finish out the second half of the Big Ten Conference.
I agree. The way Coach Kirk Ferentz puts it is that if you don't get anywhere in life without a vision, and this vision could be a good one for his Iowa squad.
No doubt about that, Danny, and that will do it for us here on Pregame.
Be sure to pick up a copy of Pregame on newsstands tomorrow, as well as Friday's DI for extended Iowa football coverage and wrap-ups of Iowa men's and women's hoops.
Then check us out on Sunday, where fifth quarter football will highlight everything from this game against Maryland. But for now, we will see you on game day. Don't forget those rain jackets. Alara and Austin, back to you.
A police officer from D.C. is quickly gaining an online following after a video surfaced Thursday of her interaction with two fighting teenagers near a Washington park. When she arrived, the unidentified officer wanted to stop the fight just as any other officer would. This time, instead of using force, she chose to challenge 17-year-old Aliyah Taylor to a dance battle.
The officer said if she won, the teens would have to vacate the park. They danced the popular tune Watch Me Do the Nay-Nay, and the witnesses watched in amazement. Taylor would later post videos of the dance battle online, where it's been viewed thousands of times. And Alara, that is a pretty interesting take on law enforcement. What do you think?
Definitely so, Austin.
I probably would have had to leave the park.
I would have
lost the dance battle for sure. But that's all we have for you tonight on Daily Iowan TV.
Be sure to check out our website, dailyiowan.com, for all the latest news between now and Sunday. For Daily Iowan TV, I'm Alara Bartlett.
And I'm Austin Love. Have fun this week in Iowa City, and happy Halloween.